Once upon a time, an artist drew a perfectly beautiful, wonderful, absolutely unique circle named Miguel. Miguel was fantastic and very round. He loved rolling down hills, squishing bugs, and eating blue crayons. Oh, don't ever do that, by the way. He was a great circle. Unfortunately, there was one big problem. Miguel didn't really want to be a circle. He wanted to be a square. In every way, squares seemed so much better than circles to Miguel. They could set things on top of their heads without anything falling off. They were great at playing hide and seek. When squares went to bed at night, they stayed in bed. And best of all, they had these cool, pointy edges for scaring away the mean shapes. One day, Miguel decided he was going to do something really amazing. He was going to become a square. That morning, he woke up real early and got rid of all the circles in his house. In their place, he put square things. A square picture frame, a square table and rug, even square cups and plates. And then he invited his square friend Rhonda over for breakfast. But she didn't think Miguel made a very good square.
You look kind of round, said Rhonda.
So, the next day, Miguel decided to dress like the squares did. He put on square pants and square shoes. He bought a square hat. He wore a square shirt that even had square buttons. And then he invited his square friend over for lunch. But she didn't think Miguel made a very good square.
You're just not square enough, said Rhonda.
Miguel was crushed. He went to bed that night and dreamed of being a square.
How much better life would be if I were a square?
When he woke up, he got out of his square bed, shuffled to the kitchen in his square slippers, and stared at his hard-boiled eggs. Suddenly, he realized what was wrong.
People always say, you are what you eat,
exclaimed Miguel. And he knew exactly what he had to do. From then on, he would eat only square things. So he threw away the round eggs, round sausages, and round banana slices on his square plate. Miguel ran to the pantry. No wonder he was still a circle. Just look at all the circle food he had been eating. He rolled up his, he squared up his sleeves and got to work. Out went the round apples, blueberries, strawberries, oranges, cherries, plums, apricots, grapes, and mangoes. He tossed the round onions, potatoes, tomatoes, avocados, and zucchini discs. He got rid of ice cream scoops, cupcakes, jawbreakers, lollipops, cookies, coconut rolls, donuts, and orange balls. He pitched cinnamon rolls, bread rolls, sticky buns, and tortillas. Out went hamburgers, chicken nuggets, enchiladas, tostadas, and peppercorn. He dumped out Parmesan crisps, mozzarella balls, cheese wheels. Uh-oh. Cheese wheels were his favorite. But no, they had to go too, along with the olives, coffee beans, popcorn kernels, and gumballs. Into the garbage it all went. When he was done, he called up his friend Rhonda and invited her over for dinner.
We're just having crackers? Well, that's all that was left.
Miguel felt hungry. His tummy rumbled. Deep inside, he knew something was very wrong. But he didn't know what to do. So he put his head in his hands and started to cry. Rhonda, who was a good friend and always knew what to do to cheer him up, offered Miguel a blue crayon. But he pushed it away.
I can't eat that. It's round,
he shouted, and he burst into tears. He cried so hard that his fat round shape burst right through the square shirt and square pants, which made him sob even louder. Rhonda got up from the table, put her hands on Miguel's shoulder, sighed, and then went home. Suddenly, a deep voice spoke.
Miguel,
it said gently,
what are you doing?
Miguel knew who the voice belonged to, but he did not answer. He was too ashamed.
Tell me what's wrong, said the artist.
I want to be a square,
said Miguel.
I tried everything. I changed my house. I changed my clothes. I even changed what I eat. But deep inside, it feels so wrong. Why do I feel so rotten?
Because you're not a square. You are a circle. And circles can't be squares because they're made different.
I don't understand, said Miguel.
You feel rotten because you're trying to force yourself to be something you're not. You're living with a contradiction, Miguel. And contradictions don't work, not even if you want them to.
Well then, why did you have to make me a circle? Why didn't you make me a square?
I made you a circle because you're special to me. The world needs circles, and the world needs squares. And you, Miguel, are a circle, a very special circle. The world needs you exactly the way you were made. If you try to change the deepest part of who you are, you'll never be happy. And the world will miss out on the real Miguel, the Miguel that I made you to be, the Miguel that I love, just the way you are. Miguel thought about that and sniffed.
But things fall off my head when I put them there.
That's because I made your head beautifully round. Why would you want to cover it up with anything?
Well, I'm no good at hide and seek.
But of course you are. You just have to find the right hiding places.
I fall out of bed all the time. And how am I supposed to protect myself against the mean shapes?
That's what I made squares for, said the other.
Hi, Rhonda.
Hello, Miguel. You want a cheese wheel?
Okay.
Miguel took the cheese wheel and ate it,
and started to feel a little better.
He looked at Rhonda and smiled.
Oh, she smiled back.
Let's go roll down some hills,
suggested Miguel.
Not so good for squares,
she said.
Maybe I'll just watch.
And off they went.